Hi everyone, I hope you're enjoying our staff's daily videos, giving us all a background of the origins of the songs of the season. On a personal note, my brother and I recently had a discussion reflecting on our childhood Christmases, which includes so many wonderful memories for us both. Our parents did an incredible job each year of making the Christmas season very special in our home. We talked about the Christmas albums our parents had music for, and they played so many times during the month of December. There were albums of carols, funny Christmas songs, and classical motifs. A favorite holiday album of the whole family was that of Johnny Mathis, which included a recording of the Christmas song. The Christmas song is also commonly referred to as chestnuts roasting on an open fire, due to its famous opening lyrics. And it's been spreading Yuletide spirit for many, many decades. So I've chosen to share a little bit of history on the Christmas song with you. In July of 1945, pianist Mel Torme and his writing partner and lyricist Bob Wells had been asked to write two songs for a musical. It was a blistering hot summer, and as Torme played his piano in the corner, Wells found himself scribbling a few ideas on paper and just kind of painted a picture of winter in an effort to stay cool by thinking cool. His thoughts transferred to the page with these lyrics: chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Bob simply thought that if he could immerse himself in winter thoughts, he could cool off and concentrate to write for the musical for which they had been asked to compose. Torme and Wells didn't think that they were actually composing at that time. However, 40 minutes later, the most performed Christmas song was born. A year later, Torme visited Nat King Cole at his Los Angeles home, as he had done many times before. This time, it was to offer him the Christmas song to record. Nat King Cole was in his mid-30s at the time, and while he had gained a reputation as a well-known pianist and vocalist, he was not yet a household name. The Nat King Cole Trio first recorded the Christmas song in June of 1946. A second recording was made in August of that same summer, utilizing a small string section. This version became a huge hit on both the pop and the rhythm and blues charts. Cole recorded the song again in 1953, using the same arrangement with a full orchestra this time. Then, in 1961, he recorded it in a stereophonic version with another full orchestra, arranged and conducted by Ralph Carmichael. Fun fact about this conductor, Ralph Carmichael: he's an American composer and arranger of both secular pop and contemporary Christian music. He is 93 years old at this time and currently lives in Illinois. So back to the subject. Cole's original 1946 recording was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame in 1974. While this beloved tune has been recorded by numerous artists over the years, it's hard to say that there are any more popular than Nat King Cole's. So as you hear this well-known Christmas song, maybe you will think about the journey it has taken over the years and reflect on your favorite recording artist's rendition of this well-known favorite. May your homes be filled with Christmas music, lots of love and laughter this holiday season. Merry Christmas.
With their eyes on